Trying to break the chains, but the chains only bring me.
Today I am showing you three different DIY pillows, and I wasn't really sure if I wanted to do this in a like separate video by themselves or as like a whole room decor video with other stuff, but I decided to do them on their own since there are three of them and it'll be long enough anyways. Plus I have another room decor video coming up shortly, but that is all that I got to say, so let's get into the video. You're just going to need a total of three pillows, and for the first one I'm using the smaller rectangle shaped pillow, pom-pom trim, and a hot glue gun. Excuse me if I'm being rude, but I don't mean to stare. I think I seen you. To start off, you're just going to take one end of your pom-pom trim and start at one of the corners, and I'm just hot gluing it on to the edges of the pillow. This is so easy and it literally took me like 5 minutes. I see you walking my way and I don't know what to say. Hello, hello. You're just going to continue doing that around all four sides of your pillow, and then when you are done, you're going to cut off your excess pom-pom trim and glue down the rest, and you are finished with that part. I kind of last minute decided that I wanted to add something extra, so I would definitely recommend doing this part first. But you can just go into Photoshop or PicMonkey or any type of place like that. And I'm just typing in Hello Spring and using different fonts and colors and just kind of making it how I want. And then when I'm done doing that, I'm going to flip the words because I'm going to be putting it on photo transfer paper, and if you don't flip them, the saying or word is going to end up being backwards, so make sure you do that. This way. Oh, no. But you're going to need to take all of your stuffing out of your pillow, which is why I would recommend doing this first, but it doesn't really matter, either way works. And once you have your word or saying printed out, just cut around it as close as you can and then center it and put it where you want on the pillow. Then taking an iron, you're going to press down on it firmly for about 90 seconds and then you're going to wait till it is completely cool to take it off. You got me spinning. Once you have your word on there, you can put all of your stuffing back into the pillow, and then I had to hot glue a little bit more of the pom-pom trim back on so that I could get the zipper open. But making this pillow is so easy and it is perfect for spring. I'm feeling it. Second pillow, you're going to need one of the square pillows, some string or floss, and scissors. And you're first going to start off by taking your floss and wrapping it around your hand until you get to about the end. Like nobody else, you know, whatever happens, I will be right by your side. You, me, in the spotlight. Once you have used almost all of the floss, you're just going to cut it off and then cut a smaller piece and put it under the stuff that you wrapped around your hand, and then you're just going to take it all off and tie that short piece in a double knot. Once you have done that, you're going to cut another shorter piece and tie it at the top of your string, and that will just make the tassel. You're going to continue that process until all of them are done, and I had about 15,
And then you're just going to place them around your pillow in the way and the pattern of the colors that you want. And I just decided to sew mine on. It is really easy. I just did about 4 stitches because I feel like it'll be more secure that way. But if you don't know how to sew, you can always hot glue it. Both ways will work.
Happens, you will be right by my side. You, me, in the spotlight.
I just did that with all the rest of my tassels, and then you are done. It was super easy. It took a little bit more time than the pom-pom one, but I thought it turned out really cute, and the colors are perfect for spring. To need your last pillow, obviously, acrylic paint and a paintbrush. And this is by far the easiest one. It literally took me like 2 minutes. You can use a circle sponge to apply your paint, but I didn't have that. I just had a paintbrush, so I just used my artistic skills and made some circles. Even though they aren't complete circles, I kind of like the more homemade, messy look. But once you are done painting your circles, then that's it. It is super easy and quick, but it just adds a nice pop of color to your room. That is it for this video. I hope you enjoyed it, and if you did, give it a thumbs up. Comment down below which pillow was your favorite, and if you make any of these, post them on Instagram or Twitter and just tag me in it. I will see it and I will like it or retweet it or whatnot. And don't forget to subscribe as always if you aren't already. You can click right down there for my last video that I did, or you can go check out my social medias. That is all I have for today. I hope you guys are having an amazing day, and I will see you next time. Oh!